Good morning and welcome to worship with Bracken United Methodist Church. We're the Schmitz family. Welcome to our worship space.
We're glad that you chose to worship with us this morning. And even though we're not able to worship and fellowship within the walls of our church, we still have many opportunities to worship and to fellowship as a church family.
At the beginning of the service, we had some announcements, and these announcements will run again at the end of the service. Be sure to check them out as they have information about the many fellowship service and opportunities we have at Bracken United Methodist Church, to include our Zoom Sunday schools for adults, youth, and children. We also have a weekly morning and evening prayer group, as well as an evening Bible study. For additional information, you can visit us on Facebook or go to our webpage at brackenumc.org.
Following service today, we encourage you to visit our page, to register your attendance, to share your prayer requests and praises, and to give your tithes and offerings online. We now invite you to get a candle, grab your Bible, and create your own worship space as we invite the light of Christ into our hearts and into our worship.
Please pray with me. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for allowing us to come together again and worship you. Please open our hearts and our minds so we may understand your word today. Please be with our military while they keep us safe. Be with all those who are ill, and be with them and keep them safe in your arms. Thank you for being an awesome God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
You dance over me while I'm unaware. You see all around, but I never hear the sound. Lord, I'm amazed.
Hi, friends. I hope you all have a fun and safe Thanksgiving break. I'm looking forward to spending time with my family, and I hope you guys are looking forward to spending time with your families. This week, speaking of Thanksgiving, we are talking about thankfulness and things that we're thankful for. One of the things I'm thankful for is my dog, Luna. She's such a good dog, and she helps me through a lot. I'm also thankful for good books, my friends, music, my family, and the holidays, like Thanksgiving and Christmas, although Christmas is my absolute favorite. What are some things that you're thankful for? Let us know. Did you know that you can be thankful for more than just the things that make you happy? Like me. I'm thankful for people who look different than me, or people who have different opinions, and even people who sound different than me. I'm also thankful for learning new things and going through changes, even when it's hard. Because these things are all blessings from God, even if we don't see it at first. And we need to be thankful for everything, especially the hard stuff. I know that seems kind of backwards, but when we're thankful for the hard stuff, it helps us be more thankful for the easy stuff and the stuff that we enjoy. He has given us and continues to give us so many blessings, and we need to show him our thanks for that and all the things he's done for us. And I want to thank you guys for being a blessing in my life. You have no idea how much of a blessing you are to me, and I'm so, so thankful for all of you and the things that God has given me. Bye.
Oh, Christ, be the center of our lives. Be the place we fix our eyes. Be the center of our lives. You're the center of the universe. Everything's made in you. Jesus, breath of every living thing, everyone was made for you. You hold everything together. You hold everything together. Oh Christ, be the center of our lives. Be the place we fix our eyes. Be the center of our lives. We lift our eyes to heaven. We wrap our lives around your life. We lift our eyes to heaven, to you. Christ, be the center of our lives.
We wrap our lives.
Be this place
we
fix our eyes.
We lift our eyes.
Be the center of our lives. We lift our eyes to heaven. We wrap our lives around your life. We lift our eyes to heaven, to you.
My friends, let us pray. Loving and holy God, we thank you for your word to us today. And we pray, Lord, that as we approach the season of Thanksgiving and celebrate Christ the King Sunday, that we may hear with new ears what you would have us hear. We do love you so, and it's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. As we conclude our series on a gift of love, we turn to Matthew 6, verses 25 through 33. So please hear these words for your life. Jesus says, as part of the Sermon on the Mount, "Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, or about your body, what you will wear.
Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they? And can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to the span of your life? And why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin, yet I tell you, even King Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is alive today and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, you of little faith? Therefore, do not worry, saying, what will we eat, or what will we drink, or what will we wear? For it is the Gentiles who strive for these things. And indeed, your heavenly Father knows that you need all these things. But strive first for the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. I love this passage because Jesus really has us humans pegged. You know, he considers us as people who fret and worry. I come from a long line of worriers. My mother topped the list. Honestly, I think it had everything to do with the fact that she was a product of the Great Depression. In the middle of a family of 10 children with a dad who was a farmer and a mom a housewife, there was lots to worry about. And then when my mom married my dad, she still continued to worry because he was one of those, everything will be all right type of people. It caused her to be more anxious. I remember her saying quite often, someone has to worry about these things. Darn it. I'm sounding more and more like my mom as I get older. But I don't think worrying as a parent is that unusual. I mean, I think that's part of what we do as parents, especially. But Jesus calls us to the attention to this issue. And he uses these wonderful words of creation. Jesus is preaching and teaching these new ideas for living in what we now know as the Sermon on the Mount. And he knew that so many of his people, the people of his day, were so worried about not having enough. And he says, God provides. Look at the birds and how they eat. God provides. Look at the flowers and how beautiful they are dressed. God provides. What really should hit home with us is when Jesus asks us a question that really is more of a statement. Aren't you worth more than they? And of course the answer is yes. But I don't know that we always feel that way. The author of Psalm 8, so beautiful, poetically, reflects on God's awesome creation, humans. And he says, when I look at your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars that you have established, what are human beings that you are mindful of them, mortals that you care for them? Yet you made them a little lower than God and crowned you, my friends, with glory and honor. God provides, and yet we still fret about so many things. I know we're all wired differently, but we still must address this as Jesus has, asking, why do we gain? What do we gain by worrying so much? I personally gain tension headaches and tight muscles and gray hair, weight, and a bad attitude. And that's not right. The key, Jesus adds, is seeking first the things of God and God's righteousness, and all those things will be yours as well. Friends, the first and most important things are the things of God, not of earth. These are the things that matter. Loving God, knowing that God loves us, seeking to love one another, seeking to serve, and give as God has given to us. These are the things of God. And Jesus says, wonderful things will follow. I love that Jesus uses creation language, because I believe that this is where we can begin to focus on the things of God and realize God's provisions for all of us. The birds of the air, the lilies, the grasses of the field, all of God's wonderful creation. It's easy to take God's creation for granted. For instance, I will tell you that most churches would be envious of all the land and the trees that Bracken has out here. Most churches are landlocked by parking lots. And so, do we appreciate gratitude for our land? And how awestruck are we at God's creation? Shouldn't we all be walking around with our jaws dropped saying, wow, thanks God? Brother David Stundle Rast, a Benedictine monk who has centered his life on gratefulness, in his book, Gratefulness, the Heart of Prayer, he says that the predictable turns into a surprise when we stop taking it for granted. The predictable turns into a surprise when we stop taking it for granted. He points out a universal sign of surprise, a rainbow. Think about it. When you see a rainbow, you stop, right? And your jaw may even drop. And if a stranger walks by, you may say, hey, did you see that rainbow? And now you share a moment. And bored and boring adults all of a sudden become excited children. Why? Because an attitude of gratefulness breaks forth. And we become aware of God's greatness in the sky in an otherwise mundane day. That's how I feel about church these days, my friends. Whether we gather outside, in person, or online, I feel that maybe perhaps before COVID, church had become a little predictable, a little hit and miss for some of us. But now, I hope we never take it for granted again. It's the same with our families that we've been distancing from. Same with our jobs that we are blessed to still have. Are you following me? Like, can we all begin to look at parts of our lives, all parts, as gifts, as surprises that we stop taking for granted? I mean, how grateful are we for the ability to breathe? Right? There are days that go by without even a thought of our breath. But how blessed are we that we can breathe and eat on our own? How lucky are we that we woke up? How wonderful it is that some of us can stand, even if we creak a little, and walk. How wonderful is it that we can come together and be in relationship with God and with one another? I believe that we should be grateful. The thing we should be grateful for the most is for each other. We should be in awe of each other. Our jaws should drop when we look at each other, because God created us to be in relationship. Brother David also says that we can help turn each other's grief into gratitude. I spoke about this a little bit on our All Saints Sunday service. What makes grief so bitter is often just being alone with it. But a friend who can sit and listen and be with the other in grief is such a phenomenal gift. Friends, are you thankful? Are you in awe of God's provisions for your life? If so, then you have what it takes to be a witness of God. I hope that we can make it a daily habit of expressing our gratitude to all around us, right? Giving thanks to God for our food, our clothing, our home, our relationships, our jobs, our health, all of it. Give thanks to God. Now, I do understand that this Thanksgiving may look different for you than in the past. I get it. And gratitude might be hard to access right now. But I do want to let you know that while this Thursday is Thanksgiving, today in the church calendar is Christ the King Sunday. And so I hope you know that our King, who is Christ, is always present. And if gratitude is a struggle, I hope you know that whatever you are going through, know that Christ is your King, your Savior, who loves you unconditionally and fully through the gift of His life and the cross and the resurrection. Christ the King is the last Sunday in the church calendar year. Next Sunday begins Advent, a time of waiting and exploring what may be birthing within each one of us. And so, Happy New Year. And as Matthew says, strive first for the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. My friends, let us pray. Loving God, thank you so much for your words to us today, to remind us that no matter what we may be going through, we can be grateful for your presence of your Son, Jesus Christ. It's in His name that we now pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. My friends, I do thank you for your gifts and your generosity that you continue to show this church. Just a reminder that Janie has attached commitment cards to the emails that we receive from her. And as stewards of this church, where we are called, I believe that one of the best ways to ensure that our support and our gifts and tithes are consistent and faithful is through committing to Christ. I also believe that we have been given this beautiful legacy, not just this building, but the body of Christ, from our ancestors and all who came before us. And it's our job to leave a legacy for those here and to come. So after the service, as we said at the beginning, you can visit our website and leave your tithe, your prayer concerns, and register your attendance. And then you can send in your card to the church whenever you're able to. My friends, God bless you and thank you.
Great is your faithfulness, O God. You wrestle with the sinner's restless heart. You lead us by still waters into mercy. And nothing can keep us apart. Oh, grace is enough for me.
Friends, as you strive first for the kingdom of God, know that you do not walk alone. God is with you and God provides. So let us go with grateful hearts in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. And God bless you.
We are one body created for you. We are the body of Christ. These are the arms to hold strong through the storm. We are the body of Christ. These are the feet to walk straight in your path. We are the body of Christ. These are the that look to you. These are